Hi, I'm Captain Brian Fancher with Texas Fishing Tips, and this is your weekly fishing report. This week is lending itself to some interesting conditions. We've got Isaac out in the Gulf that's pushing abnormally high tides, but we've still got some low winds and some hot days. Now, with all the nice lack of cloud cover and the bright days, this is a great time for you to get out in the far west end of Baffin, up here on the southwest side of it, and look for some redfish up on the flats. Now, between White Bluff and heading west, there's a lot of real shallow sand flats along there where the reds, you'll find them up early in the morning, hanging out, tailing, looking for bait. So what I like to do right now is get myself a light jig head and something flashy, a sand eel or a gold spoon, and pop them along there and look for those targeting redfish. When you find them, cast out right in front of them and work it back towards them, and you'll find them hidden along there. There's been some schools along here, as I said, and there's also been some schools coming around Clayburg Point. There's a real nice sandbar along there, and you'll find them kind of on the edge of that drop-off between the sand and the deeper water. Now, another area I've really had a lot of good luck lately is down here. When you're first coming through Baffin along the Intercoastal Waterway, if you look out to the west side edge there between the Badlands and the Intercoastal, there's some good sand pockets along the edge of the Intercoastal. Now, if you take yourself a jig head with a Bass Assassin or sand eel or something in the floppy tailed 5-inch area and bounce it along those sand pockets there, just slowly drag it along and wait for that flounder bite. You'll feel the kind of thump, and then you've got your flounder on there. There's a lot of them hanging on that edge right now, so just troll the motor along there and work those sand pockets real diligently. Now, Tide Gauge has some good fish on the eastern end of it, the northeast end over here. If you work down from here around to the Point of Rocks area, there's a lot of good trout hanging out in there. There's some good grass beds with sand pockets nearby. Look for those grass beds, find the edges of them, throw your croaker or your piggy perch right on the edge, and you'll be sure to find at least some good trout hanging out around that area. Now, you want to hit a sand pocket for a few minutes, bounce to the next one. Hit it for a few, bounce to the next one. There's not large concentrations of fish, but there's good sporadic fish marked throughout there. Also coming up through Rivera Channel here, or east-west running channel through Baffin, right when you get in here, there's a marker on the side, marker 4. Now, there's a lot of rocks off the side of marker 4 sitting in about 5 feet of water. And there's some real good trout sitting on the edges there, and I found some spotty reds. Now, the fishing's okay. It's not fantastic, so that's what I said right now. You kind of need to get a few fish and then move and get a few fish. They haven't really clumped up real well. If you're getting froggy and you want to find some more fish, though, you can run down towards the land cut, and there's a great number of trout, reds running the shallow western bank, as well as flounder laid up on the eastern sandbank. So be sure to keep checking back. We've got Sharkathon and Surf Cats and a lot of events coming up and more tournaments towards the end of this year. So we're going to be having updated videos on how to prepare for that, what rigs to tie, as well as don't forget to still register for our weekly t-shirt and tackle giveaway and troll the motor brought to you by Gulf Coast Marine. I'm Captain Brian Fancher. Thank you for watching.